Hi students, from today we are going to learn about queuing theory, that is unit 5 from probability and statistics. First of all, we discussed about some of the definitions in queuing theory. First, what is a queue? We already know what is a queue. The queue means the group of items or persons waiting in a service in a line. And generally we maintain queues at banks, post office, railway stations, reservation counters, cold storage, godowns, etc. So, first definition is queue. Queue means group of items or persons waiting for the service in a line is called as a queue. This is a small flow chart, customer, queue, server, and he get exists. Next, customer. A person who is waiting for the service is called as customer. Already we know that what is a customer. If we go to shop, then for shopkeeper, we are the customers. But a customer means a person who is waiting for the service is called as customer. Next, server. Server or service center. A person who is servicing to the center, a person who is giving service to the center, customer, is called as server. Next, service. Service means it is an activity between customer and the server. The activity between customer and the server is called as service. These are the simple three definitions for 2 marks. Now we are going to have some flow charts. Queuing system with single queue and single server. This is the single queue system, customer. Next he comes to queue and server and he get exist. This is the queuing system with single queue with multiple servers. Customer, queue, then he goes to server 1 or server 2 or server 3, then he get exist. This we can take example of a petrol bunk. If you go to petrol bunk, if there are so many people on one petrol bunk, then we go to other. So similarly, this also is single queue with multiple servers, means this is one of the flowchart. Next, queuing system with multiple queues and multiple servers. Customer, here we are having multiple queues and we are having multiple servers and then we get exist. A complex queuing system. A complex queuing system will be like this, customer and server. Next, server 2 or here he can come to server 3 or server 4, server 5, server 6 can exist. This is a complex queuing system. Next, here is a note. In general, a queuing system has one or more queues or one or more servers. We already know that. A queuing system has one or more queues or one or more servers. In a queuing system, main aim. What is the main aim of a queuing system? It is to design the system in such a way that mean time of a customer is minimized and the service of a customer is to be maintained. What is this is a very, very important point. Note this point, students. In a queuing system, the main aim, what is the main aim, is to design the system. How to design the system in such a way that mean waiting time of a customer is minimized to provide the service for a more customers in a less time. So this is one of the important point. In this queuing system, we study about waiting time of a customer, service time, server time, and server busy period. These are some of the definitions we discussed in this chapter. Next, queuing system. A queuing system can be completely described as follows. Queuing system has these 4 points. Number 1 is the input. Input means arrival pattern. Number 2 is service pattern. Number 3 is queue discipline. Number 4 is queue behavior or customer's behavior. Number 1, we discuss about the input. Input means arrival pattern. The way how the customer arrive to the take the input or arrival pattern. The way of a customer's arrive for service will be known as input or arrival pattern. Here, the time interval between the first customer and the second customer and the third customer may not be equal. So, customers may be arrived in a queuing system randomly, so we use the probability. Here, the input means the way the customer arrive for a service is known as input or arrival time. So, similarly, we can say that the difference between customer and customer may be changed. Some gap will be there. So, the time interval between first customer and second customer, between second customer and third customer may not be equal. Here we are having a small definition, inter-arrival time. The inter-arrival between the two services, successive arrival customers, is called as inter-arrival time. Next, arrival time means number of customers arriving into a queue for a service at a unit time is called as arrival rate. Then lambda is taken as number of customers arriving in a queue for a unit time. So in this video, we discussed about input, the input. Next video, we discussed about the service pattern, queue discipline, and queue behavior. Thank you.